In this video, I'll show you how to use the Remote Config app to interact with the DataHub while it's running as a Windows service. Here I've started the DataHub as a normal user by clicking the icon on the desktop. You can see I've set up a tunnel connection. And if I come down here to the data viewer, we can see the data arriving across our tunnel. Before we run the DataHub as a Windows service, we need to set up a DataHub user account with the permissions needed to log in from Remote Config. We do this from the Security tab, and we click on Configure Permissions, and here's where I'll click to enter a new username, and I'm just going to call this Remote, and we click to add a password. Now the password needs to be at least 8 characters long, contain both upper and lowercase characters, and it cannot be a capitalized word. That means it cannot be a word that appears in the dictionary, something like password. We could use password with a capital A or password with a capital P and W, but something with mixed characters such as this would be much better. I'll enter my password here, and then we click OK. And now from the list of group memberships, we're going to choose Remote Config. This gives us the ability to connect to the DataHub and to view the configuration and also to read and write data points within the DataHub from Remote Config. Now you can set up custom permissions to restrict users so that they could only look at the configuration or so that they could only view the data and not make any changes. We'll click Apply and Close. And now before we move on, I want to show you the Remote Config tab. This is where you specify which of the DataHub features is available to the Remote Config application. You can configure it to show all of the features, or you can restrict those features by simply deselecting the option. And you can set up different set of features available to people logging in remotely on the same machine or remotely across a network. Now, before we go ahead and run the DataHub as a Windows service, let's just start up Remote Config and make sure we've set up everything correctly. To do this, we go to the menu and the Cogent folder, and we start Remote Config. Here's where we enter our username and password, and then we click Enter. And here we are. Remote Config has connected to the DataHub. It shows the DataHub version number and the fact that it's running as a normal Windows user account. You can also view the configuration, and we can also see the data that's coming across. If I select our domain, these are the data points we viewed earlier. So now let's close down Remote Config and also close down the DataHub, and I'll show you how to restart the DataHub as a Windows service. To do this, we'll go back to the Cogent folder and we'll select the Service Manager program. The Service Manager runs with elevated permissions, and this is where we can define the parameters for starting the DataHub as a service. You can define a different configuration folder, or you can set a global configuration folder. But I'm just going to go ahead and click Install Update Service. And down here we get confirmation that the DataHub is actually running as a service. So let's open up Remote Config again. And you can see that Remote Config has remembered my username And if you want it to remember your password as well, you can just select here. So click Enter. And now you can see we've connected as the system user, or we've connected, sorry, to the data hub that's running as the system user. And again, we can bring up our tunnel connection. And in fact, using remote config, remember I said we can change the configuration. So let's change it so that our data arriving from our tunnel goes into a different local domain. Press OK. And to make these changes apply to the data hub, we click Apply and then Refresh. And now if we take a look at the data points, you can see there's the new domain that we just configured. So that shows you how we first configured the data hub to have a data hub user with permissions so that we could log in using remote config. We then used the service manager to start DataHub as a Windows service, and then we came back and used remote config to connect to the DataHub running as a Windows service. If you have any questions about more of the features and options in remote config, or in the Service Manager, please check out the documentation at cogentdatahub.com or send an email to support@skynet.com.